So I kind of feel as though I'm losing my mind a little bit as I read through all the comments on my Gypsy Rose Blanchard videos. And in this video, I want to discuss something very important that I think everybody missed when it comes to Gypsy Rose Blanchard and the murder of her mother, Dee Dee. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And something I like to do is pull different topics from, you know, the news or pop culture, sometimes the YouTube community, and try to see what we can learn from them to improve our lives. So if you're into that stuff, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And for all of you who have been subscribed for a while, or at least the last month or so, I have been doing videos about the Gypsy Rose Blanchard case, all right? So, those of you who aren't caught up to speed, just real quick TLDR, Gypsy Rose Blanchard is the victim of Munchausen by proxy. Her mother made her believe that she had all sorts of illnesses, but also forced her to be in a wheelchair, forced her to eat through a feeding tube, and all sorts of things. There's also a show happening right now on Hulu called The Act, which is a depiction of that story. Not everything's accurate, but you kind of get a rough idea, all right? But anyways, Gypsy Rose Blanchard ended up starting this internet relationship with a man by the name of Nick Godijohn, who she convinced to murder her mother because she believed that was the only way out of this relationship. So I think it's important, before I get into this topic, that people understand that Gypsy Rose Blanchard gave all of her rights to her mother. Her mother had documentation saying that Gypsy Rose Blanchard wasn't, you know, mentally fit enough to take care of herself. And also, Gypsy Rose Blanchard's mother, Dee Dee, also like drugged her and things like that, all right? But the argument that keeps coming up is that Gypsy Rose Blanchard, her only option was to kill her mother. And something that I mentioned in a video, you know, the other day was, I just think we're in a very scary place where people are justifying murder. All right, like in this instance, all right? Hey, real quick, I just watched an amazing video by Sarah Hawkinson, and she talks about serial killer tattoos. So although Gypsy Rose Blanchard is not a serial killer, I believe that Sarah touches on a lot of great points as to why it's kind of an issue that we do defend Gypsy and not think outside of the box and think that she had more options than to commit murder. So if you haven't watched the Sarah Hawkinson video about serial killer tattoos and why that's an issue, check out in the link in the description below, all right?
I feel for Gypsy. This is a terrible, terrible situation, being trapped and like pretty much tortured and abused by your own mother. Like, this is awful, okay? But here's the point that I wanna make that everybody is missing. Everybody's missing. Even though her mother had all this control over her, here's one thing that we're not bringing up. Gypsy Rose Blanchard can walk, okay? Even though her mother forced her to be in a wheelchair, Gypsy Rose Blanchard can walk, okay? Now, let's talk about this for a second. Some people brought up that she already tried to run away and her mom brought her back and everything like that. But she ran away to a complete stranger's house who she had been talking to, who she met at a convention, all right? But in a recent interview with Gypsy Rose Blanchard, she was asked about her thoughts on The Act on Hulu, right? And Gypsy loves the show, but she said one thing that they got wrong is her neighbor. Her neighbor was actually more like a sister and they had a much better relationship than what's shown in the show, okay? So the issue that I'm having is that so many people are saying, no, Gypsy Rose Blanchard had to murder her mother. There was no other possibility. Like, yeah, I understand if Gypsy were to call the police or anything like that, like, or social services, I can see how that might not go the right way, because you know, sometimes social services doesn't even help that much. Sometimes the cops don't help that much. But picture this. Picture this storyline for just a second, okay? Gypsy was spending many nights on a laptop talking to other people, creating a fake Facebook profile, talking to Nick Godijohn. She was doing this behind her mother's back without her mother knowing about it. Imagine if Gypsy would have got up, walked out the front door, walked to her neighbor's house, knocked on the door, and the astonishment her neighbors would have had when they saw Gypsy Rose Blanchard standing in front of them without a wheelchair. What do you think would have happened after that, okay? I can play out this series of events, and it seems like everybody's missing this. If Gypsy were to have done that, instead of murdering her mother or having her mother murdered because she manipulated Nick Godijon into doing it, if she would have done that, the neighbors would have been so shocked and they would have started questioning everything. They would have believed Gypsy because they had seen Gypsy in the wheelchair with her mother numerous times, okay? So they would have sat there and said, Gypsy, stay here with us. We're gonna call the police. So Gypsy then would have had people who aren't under the control of her mother talking to the authorities about what's happening. And Gypsy would have had credible people on her side. And guess what? Then she would have not had to have her mother murdered. And then her mother probably would have went to prison or something like that. Like, think about that for a second. What could Dee Dee have done? What could Dee Dee have done if Gypsy Rose walked over to her neighbor's house and explained to them everything that would have happened? Dee Dee couldn't have done much because this was something that was also in the public eye. Everybody who was following the Gypsy Rose story before the murder and everything like that happened, they saw Gypsy Rose as this young disabled woman whose mom was her savior, and they were taking pictures and they were going to events and all these other things. Like, she was in the public spotlight. There were thousands upon thousands of people who believed that Gypsy could not walk. So imagine what would happen once that news broke that she could walk. Everybody would have questioned Dee Dee, all right? So I think it's important, a larger issue that a lot of us face is that we are so tunnel visioned. We are so tunnel visioned. Like, you might be, and I know this is a way different analogy, but you might be stuck on a problem at work because you're only thinking of one way to solve that problem. But then, once you bring in other people, you start to think about other ways to solve that problem, all right? But in this case of Gypsy Rose Blanchard and the murder of her mother, Dee Dee, we're not talking about a problem at work. We're talking about taking a human life, okay? And this, you know, I am such a fan of, like, superheroes, like comic books and superhero movies, but through this story and other events that I've followed, like, this is exactly why vigilante justice does not work. Like, this is exactly why. Because rather than the judicial system, people are trying to use the court of public opinion. And I mentioned this in the video about Gypsy Rose Blanchard manipulating people, trying to get released out of prison early and everything like that. She's trying to use the court of public opinion rather than the actual criminal justice system. And I hate to say it, but we start to go down a really slippery slope. And that's one of the reasons why I'm, like, very passionate about this subject, because when I see hundreds of comments, literally hundreds of comments of people justifying murder, I start to sit back and say, wow, we're living in a scary place, okay? Like, think about it for a second from the side of, like, domestic terrorists. They believe in their mind, their reality is that the only way they can accomplish what they want to accomplish is by committing an insane, heinous act like a mass shooting. They believe that that is their only option. Now, I know they haven't been held captive by their mother and they haven't been, you know, a victim of abuse for all these years and forced to be in a wheelchair, but you gotta understand, this is apples to apples here. It's not apples to oranges. We are talking about people who in their mind believe that murder, killing another human being, taking another person's life, avoiding the criminal justice system, that is the only option. That is a very, very big problem. And that's something that we really need to look at, because when you have people justifying murder over here, where are the people justifying murder over there, okay? Like, all of us have the right to live our lives until natural causes take us out, barring any kind of insane accidents. So, like, yes, I know what happened to Gypsy Rose Blanchard is absolutely terrible, and I wouldn't wish that upon my worst enemy. But we need to realize there is a criminal justice system in place for a reason. And I just ask you to think outside the box and remember that Gypsy Rose Blanchard could walk. It was in her complete ability to walk over to her neighbor's house and have a discussion. And today, Dee Dee Blanchard may be alive if she would have done that instead. And I want you to ask yourself this question too before I let you go. During Gypsy's time in prison that she's been serving, how many other options do you think she's thought of since being in prison? I'm guessing thousands. When you're sitting in prison, even though I've never been, when you're sitting in prison, you have so much time to think about the other ways that you could have handled a situation, all right? So to see people justifying what Gypsy Rose Blanchard herself regrets is a little bit, it's a little bit narrow-minded, all right? So please think about that. And if you would like, let me know your comments down below. If you would like, let me know down in the comments why you feel that Gypsy Rose Blanchard couldn't have walked to her neighbor's house to not only her neighbor's mother, but her neighbor who she said was like a sister, to use that as another option instead. Let me know down in the comments below, all right? But anyways, that's all I got for this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell because I make a ton of videos. And a huge, huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. You are all amazing. And if you like what I'm doing here, you can become a patron, get access to our monthly Q&A, some of the perks and benefits by clicking or tapping right there, all right? Thanks again so, so much for watching. I'll see you next time.